Okay, Matt, go to baseline in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
What we're seeing today is a BBSRC-funded project which is about the limits to exercise tolerance. And it's in a general context of ageing, although the study we're looking at today is of a young, fit, healthy subject. We're looking at ways to understand the mechanisms that change with age and to understand what effects they have on the function of the body.
And this is Matt. He's one of our participants, but we've been performing the exercise tests on him today, and he'll be exercising inside the bore of the magnet. And what we're interested in is looking at how his body responds to that external work that he's doing on the ergometer. We'll then integrate those measurements that we've made of his oxygen uptake with measurements that we take in the magnet of the phosphates, what's happening with the phosphates within the working muscles.
Great stuff, that's good. Great work.
I've just acquired from Matt, and it looks pretty good. I've got the display parameters on this so that I can zoom in on the central peak there, the phosphocreatine peak.
The oxygen uptake is quite slow to respond to a change in the energy demand in the working muscle. So we need an energy system that buffers that shortfall in the oxidative energy that's being provided by the working muscles, and phosphates is the way to do that.
Well, I've been acting as a participant and also been running the project. So I'm a master's student with Carrie's my supervisor. So I've been helping on the ground, doing the experiments, collecting the data and interacting with the participants, recruiting them and building good relationships with them, because there's quite a number of tests in this across various sites. So you get a lot of time to build good relationships with your participants, which is really good.
The wider context of this work is the ageing population, the problems, the socioeconomic and of course personal problems that result from the extraordinary increase in longevity that we've seen. The essential thing is, if you're going to live for a long time, you need to live a healthy life. You need to be as mobile as possible.
Well, the test that you'll have seen today is just one of a series of experiments that they'll do within the magnet, and they will differ in difficulty. And by doing that, we can look at how effectively the muscles are using oxygen, using phosphates to generate energy, and all of that is linked into exercise tolerance.
So an important question is, what can be done about these processes of aging? And obviously, in general, there are nutritional approaches we might consider, there are pharmacological approaches, and there's the very, very important area which we can call exercise prescription in the broadest sense. So increasing activity, training, if you like.
With this project, if we can understand more about the mechanisms that are limiting that exercise tolerance, we can begin to understand how we can design interventions to have a positive impact.
Part of what we want to do is to understand what are the likely effects of manipulating particular parts of that system. And again, this is where our integrated approach comes in. We can't do all the experiments we would want to do. We aspire to build a model which will enable us to predict the beneficial effects of particular manipulations. So are there drug approaches to build muscle mass? Well, there are a number of these things that are being discussed at the moment. To what extent will that benefit in terms of the activities of daily life? You can only do those experiments and ask the question. But one of the things we hope to do here is to be able to predict what is likely to be a fruitful avenue to follow.